Long ago, in a galaxy far away, thus began one of the most important pieces of science fiction ever done in the history of cinema. I'm Steve Bryant. We celebrate that tonight. It also happens to be the hottest science fiction collectible out there. We only get to do about four of these shows a year. Steve Sansweet, author, Star Wars expert, probably has the greatest collection of Star Wars memorabilia, with the exception of George Lucas, in the world. We'll talk to Steve in just a moment. Right now, here are a few things coming up, including the three scripts: Star Wars, The Empire Strikes Back, and Return of the Jedi. $59 for all three scripts. About 100 people dialed in for them. When I talked to Kathy about them, C15624, you get all the dialogue, all the special effects instructions. You get all the actual character movement, all the actual direction in the script. It's a wonderful form. If you ever thought about writing a movie script, here are three actual scripts bound, each one with a movie poster on the front identifying which part of the original trilogy it was. $59 for all three. They sold out 4 months ago. That's about how long it's going to take us to get them back in stock. It'll be the next Star Wars show before you see them. A collectible that will be hours and hours of enjoyment as you read through the dialogue and relive those classic moments of not only Luke Skywalker and Han Solo, but even Jabba the Hutt. And they did all of Jabba the Hutt's dialogue in the English subtitles, and you get to fill in the Huttese if you'd like. Here's something brand new. I am so excited about this. Timothy Zahn is one of the most incredible science fiction authors I have ever read. He did a Star Wars trilogy, and we have it. It's his complete Star Wars trilogy and a short story on audio cassette that you can only get if you order this set from QVC. It's Heir to the Empire, The Last Command, and the other one was, trying to remember the other title, but all three full-length novels. They're read by Anthony Daniels, of course, R2-D2, and his short story. This takes you right after, return of the Jedi, and shows you what happens. You'll understand that Leia gets pregnant with twins. She and Han get married. She gets pregnant with twins, and they're twin Jedis. And there's a new empire rising. It's exciting stuff. You get a wonderful view of the arboreal world, Kashyyyk, the home of the Wookiees, and a real understanding of all the characters. All of that, 7 hours of listening in a box with a Millennium Falcon. The ability to speak English there for a minute, $59. And the life-size Yoda statue. These are hand-done. It takes about a week for one artist to do one of these. $414 for this. Limited to 9,500 pieces, each one individually numbered. 27 and a half inches high. Measures 16 inches ear to ear. That's even actual goat hair on that handcrafted latex. Made out of the same material as the original Jim Henson Yoda, C16422. And some of the film you were enjoying comes from this. This is sold out every time it's been on the air. The Star Wars Trilogy Collector's Edition, $87. That's all three movies and an over 1 hour special on the making of Star Wars. That one narrated by Mark Hamill. You'll get a behind the scenes look of the special effects. $87. It's all done in the letterbox, so you won't lose anything on the widescreen view. You'll be sort of back in the theaters, all done in hi-fi stereo sound. They'll sound great in mono, but all available for $87. C6960 even come with a library box to bind them. Also brand new tonight are these Cira cells. These are limited edition animation cells from the two animated series that Lucasfilms did for TV. They did one from Droids and one, actually, was it The Adventures of... Droids and Ewoks, the two series. Each one an original cell, each one measuring 50 cents for the entire set. C16483. And also, speaking of that, how about the fastest fighter in the Rebel fleet? That's on the left side of your screen. That's the A-Wing. Or how about the most heavily armed fighter, the one that's spinning around front? That's the B-Wing fighter. These are handcrafted pewter ships, $42.25. They're made in the USA. They stand about 3 inches tall. C14609, that's a little taste of what's coming up in Star Wars Collectibles. We'll be on with Steven Sansweet in just a moment. Stay right there, please.
Big Expand your entertainment options with the latest in high-tech fun. Choose from 2 hours of user-friendly, sophisticated electronics featuring names you know, Sharp, Uniden, Kauai. Don't miss high-tech toys and electronics 2 hours this Sunday at 10 p.m. Eastern, 7 Pacific on QVC.
That armor's too strong for blasters. Rogue Group, use your harpoons and tow cables. Go for the legs. It might be our only chance of stopping them. All right, stand by, Dak.
Oh, Luke, we've got a malfunction in fire control. I'll have to cut in the auxiliary.
Just hang on. Hang on, Dak. Get ready to fire that tow cable.
I think those movies have probably the best legs of any movies I've ever seen. They look as fresh and new every time I see them.
It's incredible to believe that Star Wars is almost 20 years old and
Wild.
The other movies a little less old, but they really hold up well.
They do. Steve Sansweet, welcome back to QVC.
Pleasure to be here, Steve.
Steven is an author of some of the best-selling Star Wars books around. He's also one of the most noted collectors of Star Wars memorabilia on the face of the planet. You even have, you have original uniforms and all sorts of things.
Oh, all that good junk down in my basement. Absolutely. It's fun. It's fun.
And this has become a phenomenon because as we approach the 20th anniversary, the new trilogy, if you would, he said he's going to shoot them all together.
Right.
We have a lot to talk about concerning that. But at the moment, almost 100 of you have dialed in now just in this hour for C-15-624, a set of three Star Wars scripts. And this is everything. These are scripts containing all the dialogue, of course, but all the actors' direction, all the special effects notation, and you get that die-cut cover and the Star Wars poster on the front of these. These are just fun readings, too.
And in the back, we have reproductions of lobby cards
mm-hmm.
for and George Lucas, all the films that he has done up through the Young Indy Jones Chronicles.
Mm-hmm. I mean, just wild. Not only the original scripts, but the lobby posters, and of course, if you've ever thought about writing a screenplay, and really, who owns a typewriter or a word processor, have there and say, okay, what's the format? How's it done? This is exactly how it's done.
You know what they say in Hollywood? Everybody has two businesses, their own and making movies. Everybody thinks they can make a movie, but it happens. And I know a lot of people have started by being inspired by Star Wars or mm-hmm. one of the Star Wars films, and by reading the scripts, it really gives you an inside view of how things are done, and go make your own. Go make it on video. That's how a lot of film students are starting.
Interesting. What a great gift if somebody has a film student in the family or a close associate who's studying cinema at the moment in a college or university someplace. Or if somebody like you or me is just this ultimate Star Wars fan, and they realize that the new trilogy is due when, did they say?
1998. And we're going to have a re-release of the Star Wars film in 97
yes.
with some added footage, and we'll talk a little about that later. But this is the actual format a script is in. I mean, you mm-hmm. can read a book that has Star Wars
the
or
dialogue,
something.
Right.
But this is
mm-hmm.
the format, all the continueds, mm-hmm. All the way the characters are introduced.
Camera angles,
the exterior mm-hmm. scenes, the interior scenes. So it really gives you an inside look in how it was with George Lucas standing there for the first film.
Yes.
And having a script very much like
mm-hmm.
this. Probably a little more stained and a little chewed up here and there, but very much like this. This was the format that George had and the other directors.
It's a great study, too, in motivation, because what are some of the major studios that turned this baby down?
Universal turned it down,
oh,
and United Artists turned it down.
Right up to the day the camera started rolling.
There were four main drafts for mm-hmm. Star Wars, but even as the film was going on, friends of George would come to the set, George himself would solicit advice, and so the dialogue would change. This is the final version as actually shot.
Mm.
So.
Incredible. And every page is this indelible memory. I mean, every time you open this, it's this great scene between Luke and his uncle, you know, but what if this Obi-Wan comes looking for him? And Owen says, he won't. I don't think he exists anymore. He died about the same time as your father. And Luke saying, he knew my father? I mean, who knew in this film the ramifications of who Luke's father was going to be and how that was all going to work out. Fabulous stuff. Should we? Now, well, we did this the last time.
I lost you. I got so engrossed in reading the Empire script.
Is this incredible? I'll tell you what. Should we try this?
Sure.
We tried this the last time because we know that George Lucas watches these shows. Not that he's ever invited me to Skywalker Ranch.
Okay, but that's number one, Steve.
That's a bone of I'll get it in about 10 times tonight. But we're both, since the new trilogy's coming up, we think we'd make great bad guys, okay?
I'm sure he's desperate to find actors for the new movies.
This is great, okay? Shall you start?
Who are we here?
Why don't you be Luke, I'll be Owen, okay?
I thought he might have meant Ben. Do you know what he's talking about? Well, I wonder if he's related to Ben.
That old man's just a crazy wizard. Tomorrow I want you to take that R2 unit into Anchorhead and have its memory flushed. That'll be the end of it. It belongs to us now.
But what if this Obi-Wan comes looking for him?
He won't. I don't think he exists anymore. He died about the same time as your father.
He knew my father?
I told you to forget it. Your only concern is to prepare the new droids for tomorrow. In the morning, I want them on the South Ridge working on those condensers.
Yes, sir. I think those new droids are going to work out fine. In fact, I was also thinking about our agreement about my staying on another season. And if these new droids do work out, I want to transmit my application to the Academy this year.
You mean the next semester before Harvest?
Sure. There's more than enough droids.
Harvest is when I need you the most. Only one more season. This year, we'll make enough on the Harvest so I'll be able to hire some more hands. And then you can go on to the Academy next year. Get the idea?
It's great. You get lost in it.
You do. I mean, you get wrapped up into these. Phone lines got very, very busy for these. $59 for all three. They sold out 4 months ago. They're back with us now. All bound, all officially licensed by Lucasfilms. These are the collector's editions of the scripts. Every page, an absolute memory, an absolute way to be kind of fun to watch the film and go through the script.
It's sort of Star Wars karaoke.
I like that.
Read along.
turn the volume down.
That'd be a great idea.
I love it. And you could, you know, it would look like a really bad, you know, foreign dubbed film.
Well, I don't know. I think we did a pretty good job of that. Just think how well they could do out there.
That's true. You could have fun. You could have Star Wars parties. A lot of folks have already dialed in for the trilogy. Why not get this? As we head to the phone lines, and I say hi. You're live on QVC with Steve Sansweet. Welcome to the show.
Hi.
Hi, who's there, please?
My name is Priscilla, and I'm calling from Chepachet, Rhode Island.
Hello, Priscilla.
How you doing?
Hi.
You're dialing in for what tonight?
I ordered the script for my son for his birthday next
Great.
Week.
Great.
What makes this a good gift for your son, Priscilla?
My son and many of his friends have organized a club they call the Jedi Club. And they get together periodically, and they sit and spend the whole night, and they watch the trilogy one right after the other.
Can I ask you how old he is?
He's almost 20.
Wow.
All right.
So he has seen these in the theater, I guess.
He saw them in the theater when he was a child, mm-hmm. and I bought him the set of three tapes for Christmas this past mm-hmm. Christmas. And so he and his friends get together, and they pull what we used to call in college an all-nighter, and they just watch the movies over and over again. And I think they probably know the dialogue as well as George Lucas did.
Well, it's almost like the Rocky Horror Picture Show audiences when people mm-hmm. would throw popcorn and toast and things like that. But everybody knows the dialogue almost.
Oh,
it's
they really do.
Such and a part of our culture.
Yeah, it really is, and it's meant a lot to him as a child. We had a lot of the original Millennium Falcon toys and so forth, mm-hmm. and unfortunately, as I took them and gave them away when they grew up. If he had them now,
there's a lot of great new toys coming out, so don't despair. You'll have your chance again fairly soon.
Oh, well, I'm glad to know that, and I'm sure he will be, but we're going to get this FedEx to him so he can have it for his birthday next week.
That's great.
That'll
it's a super
fun.
Present.
Priscilla, thank you for the call tonight.
Thank you. Bye-bye now.
Bye-bye. All three scripts sold out 4 months ago. They're back with us now for $59. See 15624. Star Wars has become the hottest ticket in the world of science fiction collectibles. And is it the anniversary or is it the new generation catching up to it?
I think what happened was the first Timothy Zahn novel came out and people mm-hmm. said, wow, this is still alive. This is still out there. And people just relive the excitement that they had when they saw the first film and then the other two. And that was so successful. The first three novels, Good new point. Novels, and then the toys started coming out. Mm-hmm. And then, of course, we're coming up to the 20th anniversary.
Yeah.
And the announcement by George that he was, in fact, making three more films.
So that really, I guess all that combined, added up to the incredible popularity. If you can use automated ordering at this point in time, it's certainly a good time to consider it. Very busy on the phone lines. When you realize you're getting all three scripts, each one with four color and four black and white lobby cards in the back, each one with an original, miniature, if you would, of the original movie poster. See 15624, the set of three Star Wars scripts. The QVC price, $59. And still available, already incredibly popular. And this is sold out every time it's been on the air. The Star Wars Trilogy Special Collector's Edition. These are letterboxed editions, so you won't miss any of that widescreen action. And you also get the making of Star Wars and a book all about the making of Star Wars. E6960, the Star Wars Trilogy's Special Collector's Edition, $87. And here's that scene. Let's see how we did.
To us. But what is this Obi-Wan comes looking for?
We apologize. We accidentally kicked the plug right there.
He exists anymore. He died about the same time as your father.
He knew my father?
I told you to forget it.
Now, this was inspired by the original B-sheet poster of the movie.
That's right. And this was one of the posters that was done that was never used, although you can tell by the art that it is incredible quality. Kazu Sano, the Japanese-born artist who has done some wonderful work, including some in the Star Wars galaxy. And luckily enough, someone bought the original piece of artwork, and Jeff Killian, Killian Productions, was able to reproduce this with Lucasfilm's authentication as an anniversary poster, Return of the Jedi 10th anniversary, and it's just a brilliant piece of work.
It is. It's huge, too. It's 41 by 27 inches. That's right, 41 over 3 feet tall, 41 by 27 inches, personally signed by Kazu Sano, right there on the lower right-hand side.
Has his chop down here, which uses
right
as
there,
his signature.
But on the lower left, and then personally signed along with the printed chop. And of course from Killian are the folks who do all of the licensed posters.
The new posters. Yeah. And what's different about this is to have the entire copy block from the regular screening posters on a new poster. And I know there was some negotiation going on there between Killian and Lucasfilm, but that's what really makes this poster special. And it's printed in a gold ink on here. And it just really adds to the whole poster. So this, and this is like you're staging your own Return of the Jedi screening.
A film that had a little bit of a different working title.
Actually had several working titles to try to hide it from people because there was so much publicity. It was called Blue Harvest. And
no
so
kidding.
All the production trucks and the reels of film that came back all said Blue Harvest.
Blue Harvest.
And then it had the working title of Revenge of the Jedi. But George decided well before he actually changed the name that Jedis really don't seek revenge.
Yes.
And so the title was then changed to Return of the Jedi.
It's just so strikingly done. I mean, the view of all the characters, the view of the depiction of Billy Dee Williams, Harrison Ford, Carrie Fisher, Mark Hamill, and all the, even the drawing of Jabba.
You notice there's still the brush lines on here, which gives it almost a feeling of a work of art, like it was done on a piece of canvas. And Sano has a way of getting almost photorealism, but still artistic. And so it really is his interpretation of the main characters and some of the hardware and Return of the Jedi.
Now it's limited to 5,000 pieces. You will get a certificate of authenticity attesting to that fact. Each one personally signed by the artist. And given the fact, this would be a banner time, if you're already a science fiction collector or considering it, since in 1997 the new director's cut of the original Star Wars film will be out, then 1998 the new trilogy will begin, this would be a ground floor collecting opportunity, a chance to jump in and get something that's available now that in 1998 there's going to be a scuffle. People are going to be looking around saying, what's available? What's on the market?
Poster collecting has become one of the hotter areas of Star Wars because you can store these things flat or in the tubes, and it doesn't take up as much space as some of the three-dimensional objects. So there are people with limited space by the posters and some of the other printed material.
We have a little bit of a clip from Return of the Jedi to show you right now. Watch this, please.
One more pass.
Coming around. Watch me.
Cable out. Let her go. Detach cable. Cable detached.
Wake up your wardrobe. Join QVC this Saturday morning for 2 hours of in-season styles. It's AM Style, a colorful, fast-paced fashion show featuring beautiful hand-knit and fashion sweaters from Stitches in Time and soft, luxurious silk styles from QVC's exclusive Silk Boutique collection. So start your weekend with AM Style. 2 hours this Saturday morning starting at 8 a.m. Eastern on QVC.
Do I always have to pay my credit card purchases all at once?
Not with Easy Pay. It's the easy way to stick to your shopping budget. Whenever you see this box, it means Easy Pay is a payment option. Here's how it works. Just use your Q card or any major credit card, and you can choose to be billed for the item in manageable monthly installments. Shipping and handling charges and sales tax will also be divided equally, and there's no extra charge. We'll ship your order promptly upon credit card approval, so that means you can enjoy it while paying in convenient monthly installments. It's Easy Pay, and it's just another reason smart shoppers shop with QVC.
Good. Use your aggressive feelings, boy. Let the heat flow through you.
Unwise to lower your defenses.
I talked to Mark Hamill about how they did that scene, and of course, both he and Prowse had to study with a professional fencer and saber fighter. And then, of course, they're not hitting anything. They're slashing away at the air with the lasers, the lightsabers to be added. And special effects.
Afterwards.
What incredibly staged scene.
It really is. Very dramatic. Mm. Very dramatic.
That, a scene from Return of the Jedi. We left you with a scene from The Empire Strikes Back. And this is something, I've talked about this, I think the first time we ever worked together, I mentioned that I had read the first book in the trilogy. This author is phenomenal. Timothy Zahn has a way of painting these incredible word pictures. And of course, an audio cassette. They're read by Anthony Daniels. You get three cassette books. Anthony Daniels, R2-D2, doing the reading, on Heir to the Empire, Dark Force Rising, and The Last Command. This picks up right where Return of the Jedi left off. We see the marriage of, or here, the marriage of Han Solo and Leia, the fact that they're expecting twins, and the fact that they're truly the rebellion still goes on because the Empire is starting to make a comeback.
Right. The Empire still has some ships and lots of people out there, so it's not over yet.
And we heard a lot in the movies about the Clone Wars, and this begins to explain what the Empire is doing. In essence, not to give away any of the plot from the books, but the Empire is cloning bunches and bunches of new soldiers, so they have an infinite supply of new troops.
Right.
Scary, scary stuff. A wonderful view of Kashyyyk, which to me was touching. Chewbacca is charged with protecting Princess Leia, and they head back to his home world. And interesting views, and you get quite an understanding of Wookiees in here as well.
And the only other place you did that was the famed Star Wars Holiday Special back in 1978. This is a little more sophisticated view.
It is indeed, where the Imperial Guard came in and ripped the head off of the little stuffed Wookiee. Yes. I thought that was gratuitous myself.
A little dramatic.
But along with this set, you also get an exclusive short story. This is Hammer Tongue. This is only available on audio cassette in this box set. So you not only get the Star Wars trilogy, the book trilogy in cassette form, and the short story, but it also comes in a box decorated with the Millennium Falcon.
Yeah, this box is pretty incredible. I don't know if you can see the star field in the background here next to the Falcon. But they did a great job really coming up with a Falcon that's very detailed. And it looks just super sitting on your bookshelf, I'll
tell
you.
It would. It really would. This is the kind of thing you probably wouldn't leave spine out. You leave it out straight that way and wait till you listen to how these are done. They use John Williams music. They use some incredible sound effects.
Right. The special effects there, it's almost like you're watching the movie. I mean,
exactly.
It's great. I put these in the car on my drive to work or on a long drive if I have to go somewhere. And it just... eats up the time.
That's how I listened to it, because I knew my schedule didn't allow me to read the novels, but I listened to them on tape when they first came out. Give a listen along with us, will you?
It's a dilemma, really. That's what it is. Dr. Kellering said in that precise Imperial Prime University voice of his that went so well with his young, upper-class, pampered face, and so poorly with the decidedly low-class tap cafe he and the two women were sitting in. On the one hand, there's the whole question of security, especially with...
Well, that's one. I believe that is Hammer Tongue, if I'm not mistaken.
That's Laura Esterman reading Hammer
Tongue. Yes, absolutely. That's the short story. Now, let me just pop in a little bit of Heir to the Empire right here.
Hammer Tongue is going to be part of a book, Cantina Scenes, and that's not even out yet. So as you said, this is the only way to get the Hammer Tongue story now.
Excellent, excellent. Let's just fast forward this right on through. Make sure that's locked in. Yes, it is. Okay, put that in and hit play.
Greetings, Herod. Leia felt her jaws drop in astonishment. I'm honored to meet you. Apart from the odd extended growling of his final R sounds, Rara spoke a perfectly understandable version of her language.
Wow.
Let me guess.
The actual sounds of Chewbacca there. C15-532, the Star Wars Audio Collection box set. $59, you're getting all three books on tape, plus the exclusive Hammer Tongue in the Millennium Falcon box. And also available, brand new in the show tonight, the Best of Lucasfilm's book and poster set. You get that foil poster of Indiana Jones and a book that details all the special effects and behind-the-scenes goings-on in Star Wars and the Indiana Jones sagas. $45, C16-453. And also, the Star Wars pewter statues. Darth Vader, Obi-Wan Kenobi, Princess Leia, Luke Skywalker, and Han Solo. All your choice, $61. C16-576. I guess the tallest would be Darth Vader. He's probably about 3.5 inches tall.
And heavy.
Yes.
A nice piece of pewter.
Really. We were both oohing and aahing over this. This is the first time that they've ever done a gold embossed card of Darth Vader. And we have it first, if you would. The Darth Vader card, limited to only 10,000 pieces. Each card is individually numbered on the back, and you get a wonderful description, as if you needed one, but you get a description of Darth Vader, a bit of history on the back, and there's the numbering, right? Behind each one comes with a certificate of authenticity, attesting to the fact of the limited edition, brand new today, $29 for this gold embossed card.
This is the only place to get it, not only new today, but this is a QVC exclusive.
That's right. We bought the entire lot, and we don't have them all in stock tonight, but they'll all be ours in the future. So if you're a card collector, Stephen, have gone
trading
wild.
Cards, because of the new Topps cards, the Wide Vision cards, which have just come out, the Star Wars Galaxy cards, which I had some role in, Trading cards have really become very popular, and the most popular one are the chase cards or the hard to get promo cards.
Yes.
And this certainly falls into that category. Plus, I'm just blown away by how nice it is. It's the embossing, the 23 karat gold overlay on it. It's just brilliant.
Even through the plastic, you can see how beautifully put together that is.
Plus, individually numbered,
yeah,
so it really is a it is a collectible that that's gonna have a very nice place in my card collection. I'll tell you.
1998, when the new movie is released, wouldn't it be nice to be in possession of this? Because as hot as the category is now, it's going to continue just to get more and more popular.
And you know what happens when a new item comes out and it's the first. Mm-hmm. of a
That's
probable
right.
series. So Darth Vader will be the first of what we hope will be a series of gold cards like this.
That's
and
great to hear.
Let me tell you, if they're all this mm-hmm. quality, it'll be amazing. And the back is great too.
It is the story here. Born Anakin Skywalker, father of Luke Skywalker and Princess Leia. As a student of the Jedi Knight Obi-Wan Kenobi, Anakin developed his skills to a level of near perfection due to his great ability to connect with the Force. Anakin fell to the dark side of the Force and became Darth Vader, Dark Lord of the Sith. As a servant of the Emperor, Darth Vader became the key nemesis of his son, Luke Skywalker, and the Rebel Alliance in their attempt to restore justice and freedom to the galaxy. The one I'm holding is not, ooh boy. We have, I mean, since this is an exclusive, our first lot, it's going to be the low number. This is number 54 out of 10,000. It's $29, very popular, brand new to the show. C16-493. If it needs to be yours, this one needs to be yours rather quickly. This will be our first sellout from the show. Brand new, limited edition, certificate of authenticity, gold embossed, first in a series for 20. Security, check Stephen before he leaves. C16-493, $29. Oh, okay. Oh, I. So you had that Pavlovian response,
yes.
And I was wrapping things
yes,
up, but I wasn't
I
quite
just...
supposed to at the moment. As you look at this, as you realize the kind of embossing and how difficult it must be, the original plate on this had to have been an absolute masterwork to get that sort of detail.
Well, it's amazing. It's so deep.
Yeah.
It really is an incredible, and it comes in this plastic case, so
That's
you
true.
Won't get it crushed. It'll be
That's
in
right.
perfect shape when you get it. I have to decide whether I want to put it in my card pages or keep it out separately. It's.
I would leave it in this. Although you could open this, but that's like open it at your own risk. I mean, it is in absolute mint pristine condition. When you get it this way, I would leave it this way. In fact,
probably
you,
put together by droids.
Yeah, that's
I mean,
true.
I don't even think they let aliens touch that. Just droids.
That's a very.
But it's a great piece.
Oh, it is.
And the back is nice too. The way they have the Darth, the outline of Darth. It's just the design is just super. And you notice the Imperial. A symbol
oh,
up
yes.
on the upper left-hand corner of the card.
Absolutely.
Just a lot of things going for it.
That's true, and a lot. I'm glad you pointed that out because a lot of people don't realize that both the Rebel Alliance and the Empire had their own individual
right.
symbols. You noted there was a piece of jewelry, Kathy
yeah,
Levin had,
that
was similar.
It was,
to
it had sort of that moon-shaped piece with a little circle in the middle.
Oh, this is just beautifully done. A QVC exclusive. There'll be more to come. Obviously, as popular as this is, there'll be more to come in this line and a chance to have a real treasure. There are two or three things in this show, to me, that qualify as real treasures. And we have one coming out in a moment. And it's the Yoda, the life-size Yoda, which is just wild.
Yeah. Well, you could always melt the gold down, I guess.
That's true. 23
karat. I don't think I'd do
foil.
That.
Now, probably
I don't
not. When you realize, too, also, since it is 23 karat gold foil, since gold is so fragile when it's in that high a karat
right.
percentage, I would definitely leave this in the plastic. And what a nice way to introduce yourself. If maybe you've been a fan of the movie for a long, long time, and you haven't collected anything from the film as of yet, what a nice thing to say, yeah, let me get that, let me put it aside and just see if I enjoy the world of science fiction collecting. Like everything we offer on QVC, a 30-day unconditional return policy, so you risk nothing when you shop with QVC. Like I said, if it needs to be yours, you do need to be on the line right now. It's very, very busy. C16-493, brand new today, $29, and also new with the copy on the back of all the next cards written by Steve Sansweet, The Empire Strikes Back Metallic Card Set. $48.75. C16, $375. How many cards in that set?
20 cards.
20 metallic
plus,
cards.
Plus, mm-hmm. as a special bonus,
oh, that's right.
we have the metal promo card. This is a card that went to dealers only. Very hard to get. It has the Darth Vader advance poster on it, and that comes with the set. So you're actually getting 21 cards. And I want to tell you, this sells in stores for $60 plus. This
wow.
is a really, I can't believe
that's
the
nice,
price.
That's a nice
it's
value
a great price.
For all 20 cards and the promo card, $48.75, and the metallic tin in which to store them. Also available, too, signed by Mark Hamill, an autographed plaque, $86. C14657. And we'll be right back with lots more Star Wars collectibles. Please stay right there.
This Thursday is Hobby and Craft Day on QVC, a perfect time to tune in and see just how easy sewing can be with the Simplicity Easy Lock Serger. You have the versatility of 4-thread, 3-thread stitch functions to provide the right stitch choices for all your serging needs. Narrow rolled hemming to create beautiful edge finishes for napkins, scarves, and ruffles. A free arm for hard-to-reach areas, and a differential feed to accommodate the most difficult fabrics. The serger sold out in its very first presentation and now returns for the same introductory price of just $329.94. Or use our Easy Pay option and make two payments of $164.97. It's item number V2558. See it demonstrated when guest Ann Riegel joins Delisa Crane in the sewing shop this Thursday at 5 p.m. Eastern on QVC.
Fighters more time. Concentrate all fire on that superstar destroyer.
Sir, we've lost our bridge deflector shield. Intensify the forward batteries. I don't want anything to get through. Intensify forward firepower!
Too late!
Great shot.
That was.
Talk about special effects.
And with all the firing on the executor, if you would, all the firing on the Star Destroyer, what took it down was finally one ship careening out of control, just taking out the bridge.
That's right.
With no more directional control, just right.
Or maybe it was the Force.
Speaking of which, this is a treasure. This to me is the most incredible Star Wars collectible we have ever offered. We had 100 in stock tonight. 24 were ordered in the preview. So 25%, a quarter of what we had already ordered. These are handcrafted. It takes a week to put one of these together. It took 3 months to do the original statue. These are molded out of the same material the original Yoda was molded from. This is even actual goat hair over here to give it an air of authenticity. The clothing is 100% wool. It's handmade to give it that antique look.
We have a piece of wood here for the cane,
yep.
a wooden base,
mm-hmm.
A numbered plaque.
Yes.
And the number corresponds to the same number inscribed on Yoda's hand.
Right up here. Let me just pull this down.
Okay.
Each one, only 9,500 of these ever created. Each one individually numbered, not only in the arm, but also on the bottom of the plaque right here, on the bottom of the base. There's a brass plaque that'll give you the number. I'll hold this forward. Ooh, heavy you
yes.
are.
Oh. Time to do your Yoda imitations.
Yeah, if Mark Hamill's watching, he cringes. I do the worst Yoda in this sector of the galaxy.
Now, the sculptor of the Yoda spent mm-hmm. time at the archives with the actual Yoda that's there mm. now. Now, there is no original Yoda, because Yoda was made to be flexible for the film and made out of the same latex
right.
material.
Mm-hmm.
Over the years, Yoda has disintegrated.
That's right.
But they have mm-hmm. made some resin casts from the Yoda,
mm-hmm.
and so they actually have some Yoda statues, and they remade one for a Japanese TV commercial. But this is about as close to an authentic Lucasfilm prop. And of course, it is authorized
yes.
and authenticated by Lucasfilm. It is an amazing piece.
It's so lifelike. I mean, I was asking it advice backstage.
And?
Now half of these have been ordered at this point in time. Not only do you get Yoda who is numbered, you get a certificate of authenticity that is also numbered corresponding to the number that's on Yoda. So it's sort of like a double whammy as a collectible. What I looked at him and I almost thought, what a neat thing to put in your hallway. When people walk in, the first thing they see is
right.
the ultimate Jedi master.
You could put him in in one of those circular mm-hmm. aquarium cases or
oh,
just leave him
fun.
Out. I mean, either way, it would be fine. You could coat him with a little armor all, which
mm-hmm.
would give some
right.
protection. But this is a piece that will last for quite a while. The latex is inside. There's some foam that backs
mm-hmm.
it up to make it a little heavier, to make sure the shape is kept. The sculpting of the lines on Yoda's face, the age lines,
oh, yeah.
are so detailed. And
900 and how many years? 900
years old when he passed.
When he passed.
Yes, to the other dimension.
Wow.
But, I mean, you can actually move it as you're doing.
Yeah.
You can move the head. You can...
Mm-hmm.
Now, did Yoda wiggle his ears?
They moved back.
My brother can wiggle his ears, but Yoda, yeah, I guess...
As he expressed himself, the eyebrows came up and the ears kind of
yes.
cocked back, as I recall.
Yeah. But this is also the very first piece that Lucasfilm has authorized as a replica of a real prop from any of the Star Wars movies.
Interesting.
So it's quite a find.
There are now... We started off with two dozen ordered. There are now... Over 76, it's actually 76 ordered, now two dozen remain in stock, and that's it. $414, limited to 9,500 pieces. We have a fraction of that, obviously, to offer you tonight. Each one individually numbered. Also available tonight, an autographed limited edition Star Wars framed comic. Stephen, this goes back to...
This is 1978. 77, sorry. This was...
77, so it's wow, 78. 17-year-old comic, mint condition. And it's autographed by Roy Thomas.
Actually, the small versions of these came out in 77 as
That's right.
six separate comics.
Exactly.
And
the one major. Exactly. You're exactly right. And also available, the photo card set. And this comes from...
Tops.
Mm-hmm.
And this is 1980. This is the one large-size photo card set that they did. This is, I believe, 20 cards?
I think, yeah, 20 cards. And these are original cards from 1980. So those are 15-year-old collectibles right there. $48.50. Okay, you're the guest. You get to wear.
Oh boy.
This
is incredible. This is also first time anywhere. Yeah. I didn't know this existed.
We are psyched about this. I guess one of the cult heroes from the Star Wars trilogy,
Boba Fett.
Oh boy. He's
3D hologram watch of Boba Fett.
Turn this to the camera.
And it is amazing.
You've seen the Darth Vader and the Yoda watch. Well, this one, if you look at it this way, kind of looks like a regular watch. But then when you turn it, you can see that laser-produced hologram. Brand new QVC. We're launching it today. The bounty hunter who brought in Han Solo. And if you watch the film... Check his costume out. Check out his uniform, if you would. And you'll notice that there are several scalps hanging from his belt. They're Wookiee scalps.
Absolutely.
This is a nasty, nasty creature.
He looks nasty on the watch,
mm-hmm.
actually.
And nobody ever quite knew who Boba Fett was. I mean, there was a lot of speculation that he was in some campaign in the Clone Wars at one time.
That he was a Mandalore warrior,
yes.
but we don't know what Mandalore is, was, or will mm-hmm. be. But we may find out in the first three films.
Since the first three are going back. $39.75. It's one size fits most. It'll fit up to about an 8.25-inch wrist. It'll fit down to, as you'll see on Karen, about a 6-inch wrist or anything in between. So from 6 to 8.5 inches, under $40. And we were talking backstage. You were saying that Boba Fett has really enjoyed a rise in popularity.
Absolutely. Boba Fett was supposed to be a character with much more presence in Empire, but sort mm-hmm. of got written out of it, and then apparently died in Jedi. But He was resurrected in some of the novels and the comic books, recent ones. Mm-hmm. And so, as far as we know, Boba Fett is still out there giving everybody hell.
Well, that creature, supposedly, that takes 1,000 years to digest.
The Sarlacc,
supposedly, that's where he's supposed to be.
Didn't taste well. He spit him out.
Yeah, could you eat anything that looked like that?
No, probably not. Indigestion.
The thing that I liked about Boba Fett is he was the ultimate businessman. He was not only working for Jabba the Hutt, he was also working for Darth Vader. Vader said, find him. Just find him. And as soon as you find him, take him out of action. Then I don't care what you do with him, but find him. I'll give you some money. And then, of course, he got money from Jabba.
We call that double dipping today.
Indeed. Quite the entrepreneur. We'll try to get him on our QVC 50 and 50 tour. $39.75, J17479, as we head off to the phones again. Hi, you're live on QVC. Welcome to the show.
Hello.
Hi, who's there?
This is Leanne from Hastings, Nebraska.
Hello, Leanne.
Hi.
Hi.
And you're dialing in for what tonight?
Oh, I got the script and the collector videos.
Great.
Excellent. Who's the Star Wars fan, Leanne?
Oh, my son. He's 26 years old, and he's loved them forever. And one time he had said he heard about these collector videos and if I ever saw them, so...
Yeah, these are great because they're letterboxed and you really see the full frame like they were directed and shown in the movie theaters. And you know, these videos are being withdrawn from the stores now because Fox is re-releasing a different packaging. So this is going to be very hard to find.
Well, he mainly wants to just watch them. He's got all the toys and things from when he was little and he's got them all set up in his home. He's always loved this.
Leanne, that's excellent. Hey, I'm glad we got a chance to talk to you tonight.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you for the call.
Mm-hmm. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Imagine a lot of folks who are casual Star Wars fans doing a lot of shopping tonight for friends and relatives who are big Star Wars fans. It has become such... I mean, I read all the science fiction magazines, and every time you crack one open, I don't care what the main subject of the magazine is, it always comes around to Star Wars.
Right.
Everybody is so pumped about the new trilogy that's coming, and of course, I think you're right on the mark. The Timothy Zahn books did so much to keep the legend going. This watch, brand new tonight, fits just about any size wrist, $39.75, J17479, the Boba Fett hologram watch. Now, we're talking a few dozen of these in stock at the moment. Phone lines have quieted down just a little bit. You can get right on through for it. See, $16,493, the Darth Vader limited edition 23-carat gold card, a QVC exclusive for $29.
I bet what dealers are going to try to sell those for when they buy them.
I understand a lot of people are ordering a lot of multiples on
those. Buy them now. That's my advice.
And this, Stephen and I were talking backstage, this is wild. This is a Star Wars tin poster from one of the movie posters.
And the art is done by Drew Struzan, who has become one of the most popular and famous poster artists going today. Plus, Drew is now doing a lot of the book covers for the new Star Wars books. This was a piece done for the first movie as part of something called the circus poster because it looked like something that was posted on a fence.
Very good.
It's a great piece, and it's embossed. It's in beautiful metal, has a self frame.
It's about 2 by 3 feet, about 24 by 36 inches, or right around there. We'll give you the exact dimensions when we get to it specifically. $31, see $14,599, and we'll be right back with another hour of Star Wars collectibles. So please, stay right there.
To order items only when they appear on the screen?
With QVC, you can order any item at any time of the day or night, not just when the item's on the air. Place an order in the morning for an item you saw last night or videotape a program and call us later. Simply have the item number ready, and so long as supplies are available, we'll take your order, just like we always do. It's that easy. Shopping when it's convenient for you. Just another reason why smart shoppers shop with QVC.
Mm-hmm.
Your favorite Saturday morning friends are working overtime as they head to QVC for a two-hour edition of the Warner Brothers Studio Tour this Saturday at 5 p.m. Eastern, 2 Pacific. Join this zany cast of characters as they welcome special guest Rob Paulsen, known to millions as the voice of Animaniac Yakko, and run amok on everything from caps to bracelets to blankets. Don't miss the fun in the Warner Brothers Studio Store. That's this Saturday at 5 p.m. Eastern here on QVC.
But Daffy. Daffy!
Yeah.
Got him again.
I love it when the good guys win. I really do. That's just a small portion of the excitement you'll experience. Tom, already... Oh, I'm looking down. Tommy's not there. I know already hundreds of you have dialed in for this trilogy edition, the special letterbox edition, so you're not going to miss any of the wide-angle action.
Some people have the idea that once a video is in the store, you can always buy it. Not true. They make a certain amount these things, and then they are gone and gone forever. And this thing is not going to be produced again in this format.
You also get George Lucas, The Creative Impulse, a special abridged version of the Charles Champlin book that gives you a nice behind-the-scenes look into the creation.
This has all the Star Wars stuff from that book.
Yes. A good view there, but also the three letterboxed uncut movies and a film that did a lot for my storehouse of knowledge.
That's right.
This is narrated by Mark Hamill. You'll learn, it's live TV. You'll learn just how the special effects were created. You'll find out how Jabba the Hutt was in the first, not this horrible slimy worm in the first episode.
Right, actually, Jabba was a man in the first episode, and that footage was cut. But we're going to get a chance to see it in 1997 with the Star Wars Special Edition.
That's right.
That's going to have at least an extra four minutes of footage. And the Jabba scene will be put back, but Jabba will be the Jabba that we saw in Jedi. I saw about 10 seconds of that with the digital Jabba, and it is incredible.
Oh, that's
going to be a big treat for all of us.
That is. That'll be in 97. Until then, to sit down and, as we talked to, I believe it was Leanne a little bit earlier, her son has these all-nighters where they just sit down and watch the trilogy in order. It's been aired, but you know that when it was aired, even on cable, they chopped it up pretty badly. Now you get a chance to have it uncut and to have it letterboxed. And let's let the movie do some of the talking. Let's go in. Let's watch a little bit of the making of Star Wars.
This is fun.
That over 1 hour film narrated by Mark Hamill.
Second try, too snail-like. Number three was just right. Jabba was the largest, most complex puppet ever built for a movie. He was constructed the same way the smaller creatures were. His head and neck had to accommodate two main operators. They would be joined for most shots by other puppeteers located elsewhere in Jabba's body.
Jabba Tikkan Tupita.
Jabba's eyes and some of his facial muscles were radio controlled by two more operators.
Yeah.
Stuart Freeborn headed the team that executed Phil Tippett's designs in England. It took 3 months to build Jabba, and he cost close to $500,000.
In the film Star Wars, there was a scene with Jabba himself. He was always intended to be this loathsome, large, monstrous. So I came up with the idea of shooting the scene with a man, and eventually I would mat in a stop-motion creature over the man.
Solo!
This is the scene George shot for Star Wars, but decided not to finish.
Solo!
Right here, Jabba.
That just shows you, when we see that in 97, Jabba is there instead of the man.
It won't be the rather portly man. By the way, the card is sold out, and I understand Yoda is close behind. There are now exactly a dozen Yodas remaining in stock at the moment. And the trilogy is always very, very popular. This has sold out every time we've had it on the air. It comes with a holographic box with that classic Hildebrand poster done in hologram. So that's a collectible unto itself. A poster that didn't really appear in this country until, the 80s. I guess that was released as a collectible.
Yeah, until we sold it on the show a couple of shows ago.
That's right, that's right. So in this country, in the 90s. But with, of course, that was with the original title, A New Hope. But even that, I mean, a nicely done hologram.
I think the letterbox version of this is absolutely the best way to watch these films.
I agree.
And that's going to be, as I said, that's going to be hard to find in the not-too-distant future. This way you see the full frame of the film, you get all the special effects, you see the ships flying in one way, going off the other way.
Mm-hmm.
It makes it very exciting.
It does. Now, they're all done in hi-fi stereo sound, but I don't want you to worry if you only have a mono VCR. It's still going to sound great. Eventually, you will go to stereo with a home theater setup. That'll happen to all of us in the next 5 years or so.
Are you offering? Thank you.
I lose more stereo TV systems. E6960, the trilogy special collector's edition with the book and the making of Star Wars. You'll find out the thing that fascinated me was how they made the blaster sounds. That it never occurred to me that when they fired a blaster to get that sound, they went out to a radio station tower and they took a tire iron and hit the guy wire.
Yeah.
And that's how they got that.
And Ben Burtt, who was the sound master in all these films, just came up with all sorts of strange sounds that he put in his machine and twisted them and turned them all different ways
strange
to get the great sound effects.
Master.
Let's head off to Dagobah for a moment.
This place gives me the creeps. Still, something familiar about this place. I don't know. I feel like
we're being watched.
Away, put your weapon. I mean you no harm. I am wondering, why are you here?
I'm looking for someone.
Looking? Found someone you have, I would say.
Right.
Help you, I can. Yes.
I don't think so. I'm looking for a great warrior.
Oh, great warrior. Wars not make one great.
With seeing that, you realize how lifelike that Yoda is that
Put
we
that
have.
Put that down. No, eat.
Hey, it's my dinner.
It does look very familiar.
How do you get so big eating food of this kind?
Listen, friend, we didn't mean to land in that puddle, and if we could get our ship out, we would, but we can't, so why don't you just...
I cannot get your ship out.
Hey, get out of there.
The most powerful creature in the Star Wars universe. And he looks like that.
They had fun with it.
I'll bet. Frank Oz doing such an incredible job. The letterbox edition of all the videos, E6960, the trilogy special collector's edition. Over 700 people have dialed in for it, E6960, and that's most of what we had. $87 for the three films in letterbox, plus the making of Star Wars, which is a 65-minute video giving you all the behind-the-scenes skinny, if you would. Also available, a shot of the Millennium Falcon, arguably the fastest ship in the Star Wars galaxy. $34 for this hologram. It's already matted It's 8.5 by 11 on the mat. The hologram itself, I believe, is 4 by 6. C1938 for $34. And if you like the Boba Fett watches, we have Darth Vader and Yoda available. Quartz accurate watches, $35.50. J16147.
There he goes.
And we will try to get Yoda back in stock, but the life-size Yoda statue is completely sold out. Thanks for your calls on C16422.
I hope my call got in.
That was the wildest thing. I hope we.
It's a great piece.
Hope we get that back.
And here's another great piece.
Yeah.
This is brand new.
This is a ceramic stein, pewter lid, of course, with the New Hope poster, the Hildebrandt poster, if you would. Actually, not the Hildebrandt poster.
Some of
the art from it. Yeah. But this one, the New Hope stein, for $45. C10-729. It's limited to only 19,000. And 500 pieces, and since it's brand new, we're dipping into the lower numbers. If you would, 461. This one out of
to have. I've never seen a stein or a mug that has been individually numbered. I mean, that's really something new.
That is. That's sort of like the cream of the crop in collectible steins. It's 6 inches tall, and with some great views.
And it is the very first Star Wars stein ever. There have been mugs before. There have been tankards before. But never one with a lid like this.
I'll be darned.
So it took 20 years, but...
The first lidded stein. That makes it a real collectible.
This comes from the same folks who make the metal card sets. They do really nice job, a quality job on both those products.
They do. And, of course, on the pewter lid, the Star Wars logo emblazoned, and then down there...
It's hefty.
It is.
It's hefty. Oop. You could put a... I think a good batch of brew in there.
A collector would certainly want to use this. You wouldn't demean the collecting value.
I would fill it with Yoda soda myself.
Oh,
absolutely. Well, in Finland, in 1983, they made soda with Star Wars labels on it, and one of them was Yoda. So I call it Yoda soda. Anyway.
Do you have a Yoda soda in your collection?
I have a Yoda soda label in my collection.
And you're going to as an individually numbered collectible. Each one numbered on the bottom, a series of only 19,500 done worldwide. And Star Wars, the thing that's made Star Wars products so hard to come by is that the collectibles have caught fire around the globe.
Well, I was at a convention in Cologne last October, and there were fans from all over Europe buying all sorts of merchandise, new, old. There's a big convention in Australia in April, another one in Italy in May. So Star Wars is becoming extraordinarily popular all over again.
That's something. I have some information to pass along to you. Stephen, a lot of folks ask me, you know, who shops with QVC? Well, I know you do. I know that I do. And pretty much everybody who works here shops with QVC. But in this show, we've been on the air now about an hour and 10 minutes, over 600 new QVC viewers have tuned in.
Welcome to the club.
Yeah.
As I said last time, welcome to the Star Wars Convention of the Air.
That's
true. Until we get a new Star Wars convention, by the way, there will be one in 1997 in Disney World. For the first time, a licensed, certified Star Wars convention. Something to look forward to.
Interesting. Right now, as Stephen said, enjoy this one on the air. 600 new viewers have the stein at the moment. $45, C10-729. Also very popular in the show, the metallic card set. Over 300 have been ordered just from the preview. It's brand new to the show tonight. This is Series 2, of course, from The Empire Strikes Back. Steven Sansweet.
And a bargain.
Did all the copy on the back of the cards. 20 cards and the promo card, $48.75. That's C16-375. And the scripts that sold out in the last show are still available. A set of 3 Star Wars scripts, $59, C15-624. All 3 scripts, and already, I believe, over 300 QVC viewers have dialed in for those. The porcelain stein is gone. Thank you very much for your calls on C10-729.
Put it to carbon freeze. What if he doesn't survive? He's worth a lot to me.
The Empire will compensate you if he dies. Put him in.
Stop, Chewie! Stop! Stop! Stop!
Kill me! Stop, please! I'm not ready to die!
Hey! Hey! Listen to me! Chewie! Chewie, this won't help me! Hey!
Save your strength. There'll be another time. The princess. You have to take care of her.
You hear me? Huh?
That was such incredible byplay, too, in the first film when both were sort of vying for her attentions,
right.
Luke not knowing, or she not knowing that they were brother and sister.
And we didn't either.
That's true. That's true.
Not until the end.
That's absolutely true. Well, this is highly in demand. This poster is really not, as I believe, not created any longer. So we got
I've never seen it
a value here. This is a Mylar poster from Raiders of the Lost Ark, celebrating its 10th anniversary. So that would have gone back to 1991 for this poster. It's huge. The poster, I don't have a read on it, but that's got to be 2x4.
It's a 27x41. It's
yeah.
a one sheet size
yeah.
and
yeah.
individually numbered.
Mm-hmm. Which is great, out of a series of only 5,000 posters. So 27x41 inches, $45. But you also get the book by Mark. Is it Kota?
Vaz.
And Shinzi Hata?
Yes. Mm-hmm. In fact, this is a book that we had on two shows ago in the Japanese mm-hmm. version from the Star Wars exhibit in Japan. And what Chronicle Books has done is to take the photographs and the actual pages from that book. And now it's totally in English. Mark Vaz, who is a writer who specializes mm-hmm. in special effects for Cinefx magazine, mm-hmm. Has done a wonderful job in interviewing some of the special effects artists and writing up anecdotes that I hadn't heard before. As many of the anecdotes as I've stumbled across, you'll find all sorts of new things. Even if you have the Japanese version of the book, you gotta have this.
I was gonna say,
because
surely.
The writing is not a translation, it is totally new, along with the magnificent graphics in here. This book now, the only other place this mm-hmm. book is available, is at The Art of Star Wars, a museum showing in San Francisco, and I have to suggest for any true Star Wars fan, beg or borrow the airfare mm-hmm. until March 12th. It is an exhibit of 400 props, matte paintings, and everything else that you can imagine from the three Star Wars movies. It's incredible.
Great. Where is it in San Francisco?
It's at the Center for the Arts mm-hmm. in downtown San Francisco.
Excellent.
So if you want any information, you can just call the Center for the Arts at Yerba Buena Gardens in San Francisco. But you can get this book here tonight.
Along with the limited edition poster for $45, C16453. It's the best of Lucasfilm's book and poster. And now it is absolutely last call on the Star Wars Trilogy Special Collector's Edition. It's $87. We have a literal handful in stock. It's all three movies in letterbox form and, of course, the making of Star Wars, that over 1 hour video narrated and hosted by Mark Hamill. E6960, last call, $87. And that Return of the Jedi autographed by
Kazu Sano,
the original artist, $30 for that. C14580.
We'll be right back.
breathtaking.
Great scene.
Breathtaking.
Hey, maybe we can reenact
we
it.
That's right. That's right. Hold on. Bring up. Two grown men. National television. We're playing. Actually, he needs his lightsaber.
He needs his lightsaber. That's that's the next one.
Well, that's it. See, it could be like, Luke, believe in the Force. I believe in my blaster.
If only it were that easy.
I know.
It'd be a very short movie, actually.
It would have been a short. They would have run it before Roger
minutes.
Rabbit,
that's
probably.
Right.
All right. We have your choice of Luke Skywalker, each one of these printed with the name of the character on the back. Han Solo, Princess Leia, Darth Vader, or Obi-Wan Kenobi. By the way, the trilogy is completely gone. Thanks for your calls on E6960. The trilogy is sold out. That's a perfect record for the trilogy. Just gone to the walls. If you're going to do this, if you're going to get these pewter statues, because we have, again, as with all Star Wars collectibles, limited availability to it, you probably want to get Vader and Kenobi together. Because you know what's going to happen? You're going to get one or the other, and you're going to want to have that classic crossed lightsaber look, and one or the other will not be available.
I think that's the only way they can get it tonight, in fact. So it comes as a set with Vader and Kenobi?
That'd be for 100 and... Let me just...
No, this is the...
Oh, that is right. That is... I'm sorry. I apologize. You're exactly right. That is a set. The Vader and Kenobi is a set. I sit corrected here. Vader and Kenobi is a set. So you don't have to make a choice there. Vader and Kenobi is a set. Or Princess Leia, Luke Skywalker, and Han Solo.
Do you think that they would fight each other for the princess?
You know, the only... You look at Star Wars, and of course, you can look at any science fiction series. I always looked at Star Trek and said, you know, this is 300 years in the future. Why don't they have seatbelts? You know, I mean, every time somebody shot the Enterprise, everybody got strung all over the bridge.
I never stopped to think about
that. I mean, even Knight Rider had that passive laser restraint system
so he
didn't get thrown out a kid all the time. But here's Star Wars with this incredible computer guidance on all the ships so they can fly down into the Death Star and what have you. Now they have their blasters with no computer fire control. So it's just like wherever you can aim, you're going to shoot.
They weren't great shots. What can I say?
That's true. That's true. So I don't know. If they fought each other over the princess, I think we might...
She might get her buns burned.
Yeah.
I meant the ones on her head.
Of course. Anyway, your choice of the sets. It's Obi-Wan and Ben. Obi-Wan and Ben. $61. Gosh, all that great salesmanship, and you got both of them together already.
Yeah, it's a super piece.
What a thing for your office, for your desk at work, to get Obi-Wan and Darth Vader, or... to get Han, Luke, and Princess Leia. All with
great.
The names printed on the back. I wish you could feel these, too. You're right. They
have
such a
real nice feel.
A heft about them. And they're American-made. They are always passed out along to you when possible. Just check out the detailing, even on Han's jacket, down to the holster. Princess Leia, her buns on her head.
See the creases in the cloth.
That's got to be so tough to get in a three-dimensional.
Sometimes
rendering.
When pewter pieces are made after the first 100 mm-hmm. or 200, the molds sort of get tacky and
mm-hmm.
the quality. But the quality on these Rawcliffe pieces are just great from the first to the last.
They are beautifully done. Tom, should we go to the phones? Let's do it quickly and say hi. You're on QVC with Steve Sansweet. Welcome to the show. Hello, you're live on the air. What's your name? Where do you live? Hello. You know, must be that garlic salami.
I guess.
Or they fell off the stool. C16576, you get Darth Vader and Ben Kenobi, or Princess Leia, Han Solo, and Luke Skywalker. Your choice of a set of the two or the set of the three, $61. And the three Star Wars scripts still available, $59. C15624. Back after selling out 4 months ago. $59, that's all three scripts, black and white in the back of the script, all the staging directions, all the special effects instructions, and all the dialogue from the first three films, $59. 85 for these series right there?
Yes, 1985 on ABC television, the Droid series and the Ewok series.
Mm-hmm.
They were Saturday morning cartoons.
I'm going to just bend these forward, get the glare off. These are limited edition Cirrus cells. Let me explain that to you. These are animation cells that were created from the original animation cell, if you would. So these are limited edition created cells, $98, each one with a certificate of authenticity, letting you know that you're only going to get, there'll only be 5,000 in the series, beautifully colored. And animation cells, I have a small collection of animation cells. I have an original Michigan J. Frog that I treasure, absolutely treasure. And
from
I have
that other network. Yes.
Yes. And also, I have a Daffy Duck. And they make not only fun collectibles, but they also make great pieces of room decor because there's so much color and literally almost motion going on.
These are particularly nice because a lot of the cells, the way they draw them for the frames, you only get part of the character.
That's
They're
right.
cut off at the
mm-hmm.
feet. Just, you know, they only do as much as they need. But this has the complete Wicket and Princess Kanisa. And R2-D2, well, I may not have pronounced it right, but maybe Nisa, but a mm-hmm. silent N or
silent K,
I don't
mm-hmm.
know. And R2 and C-3PO, plus they have the backgrounds. The characters are printed on the cell. Each mm-hmm. color is laid down one at a time, serigraphed on the cell.
Mm-hmm.
And then when that's finished, it's a printed background. So not only a lot of cells that you see mm-hmm. are just on a plain white
right.
Sheet,
mm-hmm.
but these actually have a background that was printed from one used in the cartoon.
And that's good to know, because when I got my Michigan J. Frog cell, I had to take it to an artist who had to draw
right.
a background before it was framed. These are already matted, ready to be framed. They're measuring in at, let's just look to be about...
Pretty good size.
11 by 14,
yeah,
maybe?
Yeah, I would
yeah.
say.
11 by 14, and the cell itself, probably about 8 by 10. But it's already double matted. These are brand new today. And your choice of either the droids or the Ewoks, a great bit of color, and a really limited collectible because those series were only on for a year. Were
right.
They?
Now, these are specially made because of the quality
right.
of these.
Mm-hmm.
Some of the individual cells from these shows are going for $200 to $300.
Mm.
So this is a very good buy on these, and they've particularly picked the poses and the
yeah.
backgrounds, so
mm-hmm.
you get a really high-quality collectible here.
Exactly. Exactly, and really, I guess a double-edged collectible, because not only was it a limited edition series, but it looks like Saturday morning animation is going the way of the dinosaur and the Edsel. There's not going to be a lot more Saturday animation done. There'll be a lot, because of federal regulations, animators can't do cartoons anymore because they're too violent. They have to go into syndication where they're not subject to the regulations.
Right. Plus, all the animators are getting picked off by the big movie studios to do full-length animation.
Good point.
For features.
Mm-hmm. Very good point. Your choice, C16562, your choice of the animated Ciracels. Each one limited to only 5,000 pieces. They're brand new today, already matted, ready to display, $98. Now we're at 400. We were 300 last time we showed them. 400 of the Star Wars scripts have been ordered. Those are C15624. They sold out the last time they were on the air. It's all three movie scripts. They're fascinating reading, whether you watch the film or just sit down and see what was going on. And especially in that first one, you can see where George Lucas' vision was taking that first
film. You're
going
to have a Star Wars party. You have to have these scripts.
That's
true. Assign the roles to different people.
Hey, if Steven and I can be Luke and Uncle Owen, you can have your choice.
Just invite us over.
How come I got to be Uncle Owen?
I don't know.
Anyway,
you picked it.
I got to be the farmer who dies, you know? Anyway, your character died, Steve. We're sorry.
Well, Alec Guinness wasn't too pleased when he found out he was going to die halfway through the first movie, but he stuck with it.
Indeed.
And we're glad he did.
C12359, The Empire Strikes Back photo card set, $48.50. These are 20 original Topps photo cards back from 1980. And almost 400 sets have been ordered, and now, again, a couple of dozen remain in stock. $45. C16453, that's that huge lobby card poster, 41 by 27 inches, and the book, Hotta book done in English.
This is the only place to get that poster, mm-hmm. number one. But this book is, I mean, you gotta
yeah.
have the book. It's fantastic,
truly.
And it is, the pictures are the same, but it's all new and very reasonably priced.
Now, I'm a big Star Wars fan, but I'm not a collector, per se. But when I see something that really appeals to me, I get it. Your first set of cards, I bought, in fact, I remember telling you, I said I ran to the phones
right.
and dialed in because I knew they were going to sell out. So I have Series 1. Before the show began tonight, I got Series 2. And you can do the same now. I'll tell you what really grabbed me. you get the metallic promo card that only went out to dealers.
Right. We didn't have that on the first set.
No.
But we made sure we got it for QVC watchers tonight.
Oh, and this is super.
That's really special.
That is. So you get the promo card and 20 cards in the tin, $48.75. And Steven wrote the copy on the back of all these cards. So for the carbon freeze chamber.
What I like about this set is we had that particular scene, the carbon freeze chamber, the lighting is so great on that,
the dramatic
effect. And when you print that on metal, it comes to light. It's almost like the metal was on fire.
It truly is. That's a great way to look at it. And the Star Wars logo, if you can see, you can see it right there, embossed on the cards. A really fine, fine rendering. And a shot of the little astromech droid.
He needs a bath.
Yes, he does. Yes, he
Desperate.
Does. Amazing the role these droids play. Mm. The fact that without them, when you jump in your old X-Wing fighter, you might jump into hyperspace.
That's right. Disappear forever.
Rematerialize in the middle of a planet somewhere.
What we all want to know is whether the droids are going to show up again in the first three movies.
Now, that's fascinating. That is fascinating.
Anthony Daniels wants to know that, too.
I would bet he does. I wouldn't be surprised, because droids are ageless.
Right.
That's the one. You know, I thought to myself, well, why doesn't Lucas continue the saga, and go on? But then I realized a lot of these characters are still going to be there in one form or another.
Right.
Wookiees live hundreds of Earth years, so these guys could well be around, and Chewbacca could well be there. Now, Wookiees fascinate me because as tough as they look with their bowcasters, they are really the engineers of the Star Wars
universe. That's right. They are super intelligent. They are really adept at mechanics, and their loyalty knows no bounds.
That's true. You could see that when Han was about to be dropped into the carbon. Have been ordered. And Tom, at this point in time, how many new QVC viewers are we looking at into the show? Because I want to keep you apprised of that, just to let you know. Over 880, almost 900 people who've never shopped with QVC before have shopped in this show, and there's still a half hour left. $48.75, this a really fine keepsake.
And you get the promotional sample. It's labeled on the back, promotional sample. So this is really a hot extra bonus with this set tonight.
That is so nicely done. And of course, those of you who are big Bounty Hunter fans.
There he is.
Boba Fett. I love it. He worked both sides of the street.
That's
like the perfect corporate executive.
And again, it's in the carbon freeze chamber on the front of the card, so you get that wonderful lighting on Boba Fett.
Man.
Just very dramatic.
Phenomenal. Just brilliantly done. The tin is an embossed collectible as well, and this will go so nicely. Like I said, I love Star Wars. I don't consider myself a collector, but these just said, you know what? These will be fun.
Yeah,
these will
just
be fun to have down the line. And that promo card can only be found in this set. That's the only way you could ever possibly get it. Is to get this set from QVC. This set out in the if this set makes it to the stores, if we don't take all the output on this, the promo card will not be available. It will only be available from us. So that makes this in the treasure category.
Yeah, you could pay at least $10 more in the stores for this and not get the promo card.
That's a very good point. Tom, should we go to the phones? Yeah, let's do that and say hi. You're on QVC with Steven Sansweet.
Hi, this is Reggie from Montville, New Jersey.
Hi, how are you?
Hey, Reggie.
I'm fine, thank you. I just ordered, I have my two kids, so I'd let them stay up late to watch this. They're big Star Wars fans,
great.
Like their parents.
How old are they, Reggie?
My son is 11 and my daughter is 8, and they're constantly watching the trilogy.
And I take it you're a fan, too.
Yes. In fact, I'm finding it hard to believe that it's been almost 20 years.
Time passes.
Star Wars.
Really?
We ordered the scripts.
Oh, excellent. By the way, let me just interrupt you for just a moment, Reggie. I want to tell people that the Lucasfilms book and poster sold out. Anyway, please continue. You ordered the scripts tonight?
Yes. My son is an avid reader and an avid Star Wars fan, so
this will be great. He'll love going through those and reading them with the other kids.
I think he will, too.
Well, you know what, Reggie? Anything you can do to encourage a young person to read, that's as good as it gets.
I agree, and something like this, I think it'll be fascinating for them to watch the movies and to be able to follow it.
Absolutely, because you can do both. It's sort of like your own little read-along kit.
Well, you've got some great things tonight. We're going to watch for, like, what do you have, about 28 minutes left?
Just about, Reggie. Mm-hmm.
It's just hard to decide.
Yep, it is, but there's lots of super new stuff on, and that's what we're coming up with. It's just great new stuff in the Star Wars galaxy.
Thank you very much. Can't wait till, what is it, 1997?
That's right. That's for the re-release with the extra footage, and 98 for the first of the new ones.
Great. Thanks very much for speaking with me.
Take care.
Reggie, our pleasure. And in that new film in 1998, watch for Steven and I as bad guys. I think
we might have
passed the audition tonight. Anyway, thanks for the call.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. Her call waiting went off. Somebody was calling her. I always love it when somebody gets on the air and they're
calling. You're on the air.
Like, do you know you're on television? No, I don't. I was on a talk radio station one time, and somebody, they cut me off on the talk radio station because my call waiting went off, and they have a rule about that, and I hadn't deactivated it. And somebody was calling me to tell me I was on the radio.
Wonderful.
Anyhow, let's pull out some more of these.
Oh, here we have Yoda.
Oh, yeah. Oh, God, what a great shot. I only did my bad Yoda impression once. Mark Hamill said, if I had to make a living doing Yoda impressions, that I would surely be living in a cardboard box.
I think he was jealous.
No,
he
does a great, boy, he is doing so
great. He is, a
great
voiceover, I'll tell you.
Really, he's doing some stuff in the new Spider-Man animated
series.
That's
right. And here we have two more shots again in the carbon freeze chamber with that great lighting.
Oh, look at the one, even on the back of this one.
Super stuff.
Just fabulous.
And then,
now, in incredibly limited supply, The Empire Strikes Back metallic card set. It's brand new today with that promo card that's only available and will only be available from QVC. You might find a dealer somewhere that might be willing to part, with the promo card, but you and I both know what a dealer would do. And you know what interests me? We obviously have a very complex computer system here at QVC and very comprehensive. We can track how many things are being ordered and from how many new viewers and what have you.
Right.
A lot of people on the card set tonight, a lot of people are ordering like 4 and 5 of these. Now, I don't think that's a collector per se. That might be a collector slash dealer. So even there probably are some dealers dialing in and shopping with QVC tonight, picking this up, realizing that if they got one from the company, they got just one. They might be getting this. They can sell the card sets separately and then sequester out the promo card.
Well, there's no guarantee that anything is going to go up in value, but when we sold the Dark Horse set of Dark Empire comics with the gold embossed for about $60 or $75 for the set, they're now going for $300 or $400.
Mm.
So get it on the ground floor. If you pass up a collectible, you usually end up regretting it 6 months or 6 years later.
Well, that's when I saw these, and of course, nobody ever collects anything that thinking anything's going to go up in value.
You buy it because you like it. Oh, absolutely.
It's fun.
Absolutely.
I looked at this set and said, this is just going to be fun to sit down every once in a while and to look. And let me just back on the back of this card. Cold assault stormtroopers, or snowtroopers, were specially assembled by General Veers to storm the rebel base on Hoth. The elite Blizzard force, which disembarks from kneeling Imperial walkers, has the training and the equipment to quickly mop up the rebels. And the writing continues. Steven did all the writing. In very short supply right now. You've seen a lot of sellouts tonight. This is going to be next. $48.75 with that QVC exclusive promo card. Coming up in the next hour, the jewelry showcase, we have a 7-inch flexible herringbone bracelet, 4.3 grams of 14 karat gold. This is $87. It's reversible. It has a sparkling diamond cut border and center, all done on flexible herringbone. 7 inches long, over 4 grams of 14 karat gold, $87. And also, if you've been admiring the watch I've been wearing, this is from Missoni. Missoni, world-famous fashion designers, known for their geometric prints, their wild, striking looks. This is a Swiss chronograph. A Swiss quartz chronograph. It's $169.26. Now, this isn't available now, but if you've been looking for a chronograph that splits things down, it keeps great regular time, but also splits things down into tenths of a second on the stopwatch, it is J23981. Write that down. J23981 with that dark, sort of a, I guess, a cocoa brown leather strap. 169.26. It'll fit a wrist up to about 8.5 inches. It's water resistant down to about 150 feet. And all that in a Swiss accurate chronograph. It's also going to be offered on Easy Pay, I believe, 3 payments. This is a $50 and change. $169.26 will be the one-time only price. That'll be up in the jewelry showcase in about, according to my Swiss chronograph, in about 23 minutes from right now.
Oh my goodness, you have to hold on tight. Everything's flying.
Every single design sold out in our premiere presentation. Now those rich, regal gems are finally back in our two-hour Brazilian amethyst special. From the remote mines of Brazil, the foremost source of amethyst in the world, come some of the finest amethysts ever unearthed and a fabulous collection of rings, bracelets, earrings, and more. Don't miss the return of the Brazilian Amethyst, 2 hours, this Monday beginning at 9 p.m. Eastern, 6 Pacific, here on QVC.
It's Sewing Made Simple this Thursday as we celebrate our Fabrics Crafts first anniversary with the premiere of the Simplicity 12-stitch sewing machine. From mending buttons to customizing fashion, this full-size portable sewing machine has the right stitch to meet most home sewing needs. It has 12 stitch functions, fully variable stitch length and width, and a free arm for hard-to-reach areas. The sturdy all-steel frame means durability and long-lasting performance, and a built-in handle makes portability easy. Your introductory price for the Simplicity 12-stitch sewing machine is just $117.64. It's item number V7401. Don't miss its debut when guest Ann Regal joins me, Judy Kroll, for 2 hours of our Fabric Crafts first anniversary as Hobby and Craft Day continues Thursday at 10 a.m. Eastern on QVC.
Whatever your hobby, QVC's got all the supplies you need to enjoy it. Tune in throughout the day this Thursday during our Hobby and Craft Day. You'll find more than 13 hours of hands-on craft ideas. Explore the creative possibilities from over 100 projects offered throughout the day. Look for lots of easy-to-follow demonstrations and see how our many special guests turn simple materials into beautiful designs. Before you start your next craft project, sample QVC's Hobby and Craft Day with more than 13 hours of choices all day Thursday.
That ought to hold for a while.
Quick, we've got to get across. Find the controls that extend the bridge.
I think I just blasted it.
They're coming through!
It doesn't look, Stephen was just saying, it doesn't look like they're a foot and a half off the floor at that point in time. Well, Jabba's sand barge didn't look like it was taking place in Arizona.
That's
either.
Right.
So the magic of film.
The magic.
Well, if you watch these science fiction shows, you know that I am fascinated by the technical gobbledygook. If you're like me, this is a must-have. First of all, it satisfies two needs. You get these chrome art movie posters.
These are brand new.
These are.
I haven't seen these before either. These are great.
Strikingly done from all three films.
It's hard.
A little bit hard to.
Yeah,
there you go.
Okay,
there you can see from The Empire Strikes Back.
That's the advance sheet for Empire.
Mm-hmm.
The first style A sheet from Jedi.
Right.
That's actually George Lucas's hands modeling that.
I'll be darned.
And the style C, this was the international art.
Right.
for Star Wars. And these are all the chromium prints that ZenArt does so well. It's the first time they've done actual posters, the one sheets.
And the thing I like about this is the value point, because you're talking all three chrome art pieces. Now, for $59.50, that would be a fine buy.
By itself, yeah.
But also, you get a blueprint portfolio with some of the most popular craft from the Star Wars galaxy. And to show you what a techno geek I am, okay, the B-Wing Starfighter blueprint. The B-Wing, the most heavily armed of all the Rebel starfighters. The AT-AT Walker, which marked, a new level of excellence in computer-generated and live-action animation. Just incredibly done. The A-Wing starfighter, the fastest fighter. The one designed to compete against the new Imperial TIE fighter.
These are really handsome prints, and most of these, they have four views, top, bottom, front, rear, or side views. Some of them have two views, but they're just great.
They are, but a really fine rendering. And of course, the TIE fighter, acronym for Twin Ion Engine Fighter, the Empire's finest. The Y-Wing. Now, as you see these craft, you're saying, okay, how come there are so many different designs? Can you say Kenner? No. How come there are so many different designs? There are different designs because the ships had, well, I guess I blew it with George right there. What? They had different designs because they had different functions.
That's right.
The Y-Wing fighter was the most heavily shielded of all the craft, so it had to be bigger. This baby could take a pounding and just keep on coming at you. Really, really fierce.
Take a licking and keep on ticking. Yeah,
something
that
like that.
Before.
Take a lasering and keep on phasering.
Right. I like that.
Okay. And of course, the Imperial Star Destroyer, the Executor.
Now that was supposed to be over 6 miles long in the Star Wars world.
Oh,
and
man.
Actually, the special effects models seem like 6 miles long.
They were huge. They were like 30 feet,
right? Oh, yeah,
something
incredible.
Massive.
Incredible.
Massive. But in addition to that, of course, the X-Wing fighter. Steven and I were talking about this. One of the cult heroes arising from Star Wars, Wedge Antilles, was given the opportunity to jump into one of the new A-Wing babies because it was supposed to be a lot faster. And he said, no, I'm one with the X-Wing.
Thanks.
I'm hanging in there. The X-Wing, of course, interesting point, when it fires its lasers in Star Wars mythos, the laser generators, the laser emitters, degenerate a little bit. They actually erode and they have to be replaced, so it cannot fire its lasers infinitely without getting serviced. And of course, the
all-terrain scout walker.
That's right. Look at how detailed these are. I mean, it's like if you had enough sheet metal, you could go out and maybe put one of these guys together in your backyard. Then your neighbors would
not my backyard.
Your neighbors would be wondering about
these. These all come in this really nice portfolio. It's great. Blueprint. There haven't been good Star Wars blueprints for years.
These are so, these are so
nicely done.
Just nicely detailed. All in the folder, all eight of these, and the three chrome art pieces, all of this brand new tonight, under $60. We'll head off to the phones again.
Good price.
Hello there, you're live on QVC with Steven Sansweet. Welcome to the show.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi, what's your name? Where do you live, please?
I'm Aaron from Waterloo, New York.
Hi, Aaron.
Aaron?
Aaron.
Aaron, how old are you?
14.
All right. Welcome to QVC, Aaron. How are you enjoying the show so far?
I love it.
Well, thank you. Thank you very much. You sound like a big Star Wars fan.
Yeah, I collect some of the stuff, the older stuff I've gotten. Thanks.